For a number of weeks now, I have had what I believed at least to be the mind of the Lord concerning this service, what he would have me to preach upon, teach upon. And I believe I have his mind as to how he would have us conclude the service. I want everyone that would you come and stand in this altar with me quickly, please? All across the sanctuary, would you come and stand in the altar? Brian, your presence is heaven to me. That'll be great. This is what I want us to do when we arrive in the altar. Brother Swigert and I were speaking about age at lunch. Age really is relative. But I want someone that is of the Elijah generation to find someone in this altar that is of the Elisha generation. Hear me tonight. The only way we're going to make it is together. I said the only way we're going to make it is together. I said the only way we're going to make it is together. The book says a three-strand cord is not easily broken. And I've had just about enough of the devil dividing the nations. I honestly believe, I don't want to get into the context and I don't want to spiritualize a text. God forbid, everyone that knows my ministry knows that I stay far from such. But I really think there in Malachi, when he talks about the hearts of the fathers being turned to the children and the hearts of the children to the fathers, lest I curse the earth. I'm telling you, there's a curse on this country. And I believe one of the keys to breaking it is for generations to come together. Tonight I'm going to ask again for you to pray for someone that is of another generation. This is how we're going to do this tonight, okay? I'm going to ask Brother Gabe, Pastor Gabe, Pastor Swaggart to help us. They represent different generations. I'm going to ask Pastor Gabe to first go and pray and bestow honor. Give honor to whom honor is due. And as he lays his hands on his grandfather and leads us in prayer, I want some of you younger to turn around and find somebody that's older than you. Maybe two or three people can get together. I want you to lay hands on them, and I want you to pray as Pastor Gabe leads us. Pastor Gabe, take that microphone, lay your hands on your grandfather, and I want you to lead us, giving honor where honor is due. Come on, saints. I believe something's about to happen right here. I believe that. In Jesus' name.
Heavenly Father, we come before you in the name of Jesus. And Father, we thank you for this generation. We thank you for my grandparents. We thank you for the price that they have paid to lay the groundwork that we have here today. And Lord, we're asking for a greater anointing right now in the name of Jesus. For there are still more souls that need to be saved and need to hear this gospel. Father, we pray right now for a greater anointing, a greater power, a greater authority right now in the name of Jesus. And we love you this evening, and we thank you in advance for what you're going to do. For Lord, as he has said many number of times, he may be old and stricken in years, but there is still much more land to be possessed. Yes. Yes. And we declare that in the name of Jesus, yes, that there is still more land to be possessed. And we thank you right now. and we praise you and we worship you and we pray honor upon my grandparents. We pray blessing upon my grandparents. We pray health upon my grandparents. In the name of Jesus, give them many more years to come. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray.
Yes, Jesus.
Amen and amen.
Hallelujah. I'm telling you, I sense something. Something's starting to break. Brother Swaggart, take that microphone, lay your hands on Gabe, and pray for the next generation. The next generation. The next generation. Come on, saints. Some of you elders, turn now and begin to pray for the younger as Pastor Swaggart leads us.
Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, we believe you for a mighty outpouring of the Holy Spirit upon this generation. Lord, to touch their hearts and touch their lives. Satan cannot have that generation. Satan cannot have that generation. Satan cannot have this nation. Satan cannot have anything that belongs to God. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray your power, O Lord, to fill Gabe's heart, mind, soul, and spirit. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, we ask it. Praise God.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Your presence. Come on, lift your hands and worship Him.
Sing it now, church, your presence. It is heaven to me.
Yes, it is.
Again, please, Brian, your presence is heaven.
Oh, my Lord, your presence,
your presence
is heaven. My Lord, to me.
Thank you, Jesus.
Jesus, your presence,
is
Hallelujah.
Glory,
hallelujah.
Glory.
Come on, give the Lord a hand clap of praise tonight. Jason, thank you for that word tonight. I'm telling you, I felt it when he was ministering We've got to come together. And I believe that this church can be an example of that very thing, people coming together for one purpose, and that is to spread the gospel of Jesus Christ. Do you know we actually have an opportunity to tell and to show the whole world that the generations can come together,
yes,
in harmony, in, yes, unity, for the purpose of declaring the gospel of Jesus Christ. And I believe we are doing that. And I believe we must do that. Turn around and tell your neighbor you love them. Be back with us Wednesday night for our midweek Bible study. We love you. God bless you.
Jesus, I'll never forget what you've done for me.
Jesus, I'll never forget how you set me free. Jesus, I'll never forget how you brought me out. Jesus, I'll never forget. No.
Forget what you've done for me.
Jesus, I'll